Today, I'll show you how to export VRoid models to Unity to begin using your VRoid character in your game. This tutorial will cover all standard 3D pipelines, universal render pipeline, and high definition render pipeline. It's quick and simple, so let's get to it. The first step is to create a character in VRoid Studio. If you don't have VRoid Studio installed, there's a link in the description which will take you to the official download page. I personally think that VRoid Studio has a potential to be used in game development, especially games with anime art style. This application is quite powerful. You can create your own custom character by pressing this plus button. You can modify the face of the character. You can create each strand of hair complete with physics rigging. You can create custom clothing. And you can preview animations. There are a lot of videos on YouTube already covering the basics of VRoid Studio, so I won't explain every function in this video. For the purpose of this tutorial, I'm going to use a pre-made model provided in the application. But feel free to use your own model and follow along. To export your model, we can go to the Camera Exporter tab, and then we're going to choose the Export menu on the left. On the top right side of the window, we can see this model's amount of triangle mesh, the amount of materials, and the amount of bones in the rig. We can play around with the sliders to reduce and optimize performance when this model is used later. This is important if we want our game to run on older device. But too much optimization will make our character look jagged and twisted, so do it in moderation. Once we're done, we can press on the export button, fill out the character information, and choose the directory for the exported file. VRoid Studio will then generate a .vrm file. You can't edit this VRM file back, so remember to save your VRoid project if you want to edit your model later. Somebody has already created an importing plugin to Unity, so we just need to download a plugin called UniVRM. Go to the second link in the description and we'll be taken to this GitHub page. We need to scroll down and click on this release page. Then below the newest version, we want to scroll down and click this asset text to find the Unity package that we need. Click to download it. Now, we're going to move to Unity. But first, I have to warn you that there is an extra step if you decide to use URP and HDRP project. For those who don't know, URP stands for Universal Render Pipeline, and HDRP stands for High Definition Render Pipeline. They basically allow you to work with more advanced graphic settings like shaders and post-processing. But don't worry, we'll cover both regular 3D, URP, and HDRP in this video. So let's create a new project of your choosing, and wait for it to load. Once Unity is open, we want to install UniVRM package that we just downloaded. Right-click on the asset folder, select Import Package, Custom Package, and locate our UniVRM package file. Next, Unity will show this import window. Select All and click Import. There might be a warning about script updating consent, just click Yes and for other files. And one more warning to use linear color space, click Use Recommended Layer. If the importing process is successful, you will see two new VRM folders on your asset window, and a new VRM 0 menu on the top side of the screen. Finally, to import our model, we will click on that VRM 0 menu, select Import, and locate our VRM model from VRoid Studio. A new window will open to choose where we would like to save the prefab. So let's create a new folder called prefabs and choose that folder. Then click open. If all goes well, when we put our VRM prefab, we will see our model without problems. But if you choose the URP or HDRP before, your model will appear pink, which is a sign of missing texture or incompatible shader. Unfortunately, the shader from this plugin is only compatible with standard render pipeline and regular 3D project. But there are workarounds that we can do. We need to change the shader with another shader that works with URP. A guy actually recreated the entire shader from scratch in Shader Graph, which is awesome. So let's go to the third link in the description, which will take you to this GitHub page. Then click on this green code button and choose download zip. Now we want to extract this zip file and drag the extracted folder to the project window in Unity. If there is a warning like this, just click OK. Now that we imported the new shader, we want to replace the shader in all materials used by this character. To do that, we first open up the prefab folder, then materials folder. We want to select all materials in this folder, so click on the topmost material, hold shift on your keyboard, and click on the bottommost material, then let go of the shift button. In the inspector window, click on the shader option dropdown, choose shader graphs, mtune, and boom! Right away, we can see that it's working. So there you go. We managed to export a character from VRoid Studio and import it into Unity. If this video helps you, then don't forget to like the video. In the next video, I will show you how you can implement custom animation from Mixamo, which is a free AI-powered 3D animation website. So, if you want to see that video, consider subscribing and ring the bell so you'll be notified when that video goes up. And with that, I'll see you guys later. Goodbye.